In this video, I'm going to show you how to set the clock on your AudioMoth for Eclipse Soundscapes Data Collectors. First, make sure that your AudioMoth has three AA batteries already installed. You're going to start by looking at the side edge near the rounded bump dot. There is a tiny little switch underneath that circuit board on the edge, and there's three spots: custom, which is closest to the bump dot, the center one, USB off, and default. Right now it should be in USB off. I'm going to move it towards the bump dot to custom. Then I'm going to turn the AudioMoth around to the side where the micro SD card and USB port is located. And I'm going to look for the lights. The lights help me figure out a lot of different things about the AudioMoth. And in this situation, we are using them to help us figure out if the clock is set. Right now I can see the green light is flashing and the red light is just a steady light. It is not set. So I'm going to press the time chime button on the eclipsesoundscapes.org website to play the time chime sound, which should help set this. I'm going to play that now. The lights switch a bit, and then eventually there will just be a flashing red light. At this point, I know that the clock is set. And so I'm ready to turn it off until it's time to deploy the AudioMoth to record. I'm going to turn it back around near the rounded bump dot, move the switch to the center, which is the USB off.